Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today in this video, we are going to demonstrate and describe our emitter follower circuit kit. Emitter follower circuit is also known as common collector circuit. In this circuit, we have used the NPN transistor with a common collector configuration. By this common collector configuration, we can find out the voltage gain, input impedance and output impedance of a common collector circuit. Generally, emitter follower and common collector circuit are used when the high input impedance and low output impedance is required, and the current gain of this impedance and this type of configuration is very high, but the voltage gain is lesser than the unity always. So this is the basic emitter follower circuit. The order code for this kit is 36122. You can find out all the specification and about, you can purchase this order code by visiting our website, which is www.tesca.in. This is the power on off switch for this kit. This is a jewel light in this. As we power on off the switch, the jewel light will indicate the switch circuit kit is on. In this, we are providing a basic circuit of a emitter follower or a common collector circuit. In this, we are using BC547 silicon type of NPN transistor, and the circuit consists of input resistance and capacitor, and this is the output side of this input. This circuit generally works on 9 volt DC supply, which are internally connected with the 9 volt DC regulator. We are also providing different resistance, input resistance in the circuit. By this knob of 3 input selector, you can change the required resistance. First is the 15k, second is 22k, and third one is the 27k of resistance. Any of the selective resistance are provided as required. We are also providing a user manual to the detailed study, and circuit diagrams are given in the user manual. You can perform the experiment given in the user manual by following the procedure. Also providing some patch codes for connections of the circuit diagrams. So now we will perform the first experiment and the single experiment with this kit. So this is to study the overall characteristics of a emitter follower amplifier, and to find, we will find the voltage gain, input impedance and output impedance of this circuit. So we will follow the procedure and draw the circuit connection as given in the procedure. So we will resemble this circuit of emitter follower at the kit. So for this, we will first connect A to B. So this is A point of this circuit. This will be connected with B point here, and B will be connected with C. So that's how we connect our connections. Now this is resembling the emitter follower circuit given in the user manual. As per the user manual, now we will give the input from the audio frequency generator of 1 kHz and 0.30 volts. Now you can see that I have set the amplitude about 0.3 VPP and frequency has been set to 1000 Hz or 1 kHz as required, as described in the manual. Now we will give this input, so this output of this audio amplifier, to the input of the circuit. So positive will be connected to input terminal and negative will be connected to ground. So we have given the input of the audio frequency at 0.30 VPP. Now we will see the output from the oscilloscope or DSO. Right now we are using DSO. If you want to very sharp output, you can use CRO, as the low value of the voltages can easily be detected on CRO. So we will connect the output here. So you can see the output amplitude right now is showing about 435 millivolts, and the frequency is already measured, which is about 1 kHz. So the frequency is very less, that's why DSO is not able to catch the frequency. With the later, we will increase the frequency and get the output. Now we will introduce the decade resistance box of order code 19002. So this is the decade resistance box with a range of 1 ohm to 1000 1000 kilo ohms, you can select any of the different resistances from this. Now we will add this resistance box at the output terminal. So positive and negative will be connected, positive and ground will be connected to the output terminals. So we will add this at the output, and now we will find the input gain by selecting the range. As we will adjust the resistance in this manner that the value of the output amplitude right now we are showing here should remain half of this value. So we will try to manage this, then make this value half. So we will find out the resistance, which is the input resistance. So I will adjust this value of decay resistance and try to measure and make the value about half. So as I increasing the resistance from 1 ohm in 10 steps, so 1 ohm is very less resistance, that not affecting the value. Now we will increase the 10 ohms one by one. This is not affecting the value. Now we will increase the 100 ohms. So we have to find a proper value by changing the different resistances and imply the different values of resistance, so the output level will goes half of this. Now due to we are using DSO, so DSO is right now not able to catch the very lower voltage, so we have set the value of this amplitude around 1 ppb. So check the value at different values. So we have set the value right now 1 ppb. Now we will observe the output here. You can see the amplitude also giving in the measurement is 1 millivolts, similar to the output. Now we will introduce the resistance and do the same value at this voltage range. Now for adding the resistance, connect the both red terminals of this decade box with the positive and negative. Now as you connect, you will see the output waveform goes very distorted. Now we will increase the resistance and we will see the value and the waveforms all also changes. So as I increase the value here of 10 ohms, you can see the value or the waveform slightly increases here, you can see. So till we match the half value, we will increasing the resistance. So right now you can see our amplitude is about 1 millivolts. So we will make this this value about 500 millivolts. So we will achieve the appropriate input impedance. So right now we can say this is about 500 ohms. Yes, that's we achieve the 500 millivolts in the output level. So this at this time that what the resistance is showing from the decade resistance book, which is about the 104 ohms around. So this is the appropriate input resistance that we are finding with this circuit. You can also observe the waveform when we applied the input impedance and output signal at the user manual, which is showing similar as we have get the value. So this is how we get the input impedance. Now we will find out the output impedance. For this we will connect this decade resistance box at the input side. Now we will find out the output impedance of this circuit. So as you see right now the output is 1 volt at the CRO, or the DSO that we are using right now. So 1 volt is the output and 1 kilohertz is the frequency. Now we will introduce this decay resistance box to the input side. So as I introduce this decay resistance box to the input side, you can see the waveforms completely distorted. Now we will increase the resistance and find the appropriate resistance. At this, the value of the input or the output that was showing about 1 volt now reaches about 500 millivolts. So that was the half of this value. At this point, the resistance that we have get, this is the output impedance of the circuit. So now we will increase the value from decay resistance box and find out the waveforms. So right now I am increasing the value. So this is around 550 and around 500 volts. So this will be the 110 ohms and the input impedance was 104 ohms. So when we find out the gain of both the inputs, you will find out the gain, voltage gain easily. So this is the right now value of resistance of output impedance. So now we will make the bootstrap circuit or the complementary meter follower circuit with this circuit also, and we can find out the frequency, corresponding frequency responses, output impedance and input impedance as we have found out earlier. So I will make you the show you how to make the bootstrapping circuit. So for this we will connect a page code from C to A. So this is the C terminal, this will be connected with A, and D will be connected with C, and B will be connected with E. So this is the basic circuit of complementary meter follower or the bootstrap circuit. So now we can find the frequency response, output impedance and input impedance as explained earlier. So we will give the input to the circuit here and see the output at the DSO. So right now you can see the input from the audio amplifier is about 1.2 VPP, which is the 1.2 volts, and similar output is also measuring at the CRO or the DSO, which is 1.23 around. So there is a little issue with proper accuracy with this DSO, but you can measure the appropriate with the CRO when you connect the CRO proper. Now we will make and find the corresponding input and output resistance as we find out in the earlier experiment process and earlier circuit. So as we connect decay resistance box to the input, sorry, to the output, here we can find the output. Right now the output is not about the half, so we will change the decay value to make this about the half. So right now this is almost half value of the input resistance. So that's how you find out the bootstrapping output and calculate the voltage gain, input impedance and output impedance by following the earlier procedure. So this is how the emitter follower or the common collector configuration of a NPN transistor works with these kits. So in practical value, you can find the exactly half value of the input wave voltage, but some of the cases in bootstrap like this, you have to settle the waveforms around the till the waveform does not distort. So right now you can see the waveform is about in distortion, and as I increase some of the resistance, the waveform is proper. So at this point we have to consider this resistance value as the output input impedance. Similarly, you can also find the input impedance as doing the earlier experiment, and you can find out the gain and frequency responses, and you can also repeat such all steps with different resistance values, so you will find the different readings of the emitter follower circuits. So that's how we perform the input impedance, output impedance and voltage gain experiment of the emitter follower circuit or the common collector circuit with an NPN transistor. You can also do the experiment as I explained in this video, and while performing the experiment, if you find any difficulties, you can refer to user manual or you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all the supports. Thank you.